technically in Toronto at the moment. Okay. I don't really know how to start this because there are some things that I want to say, but also, all right. So today is my first full day in Canada. I got here yesterday much later than I had initially planned. I was kind of like nonchalant about this trip for multiple reasons. I honestly thought about canceling it, but I couldn't cancel this hotel and I didn't want to be like out of a lot of money. So I got to the airport and, you know, I thought I had like plenty of time, and it turns out the cutoff to check in your bag for international flights is 1 hour. So I missed that cutoff time, and even though I could have easily made the fucking flight, they would not let me go without my bag. I got here much, much later than I had intended. And when I got here yesterday, I was like kind of deflated, I think just from the traveling, which is crazy because the flight was less than an hour, but just that whole commotion that my day didn't start it how I planned. And, you know, again, it turns out that I'm staying in Brampton, not in Toronto, and I'm here to be in Toronto. And it's not the end of the world, just again, like, this is my first time traveling completely alone outside of the States. So like, it's a learning experience. This whole trip is going to be a learning experience. I'm at a hotel that's kind of on the outskirts of like town or whatever. So I like went, I got sushi yesterday, and then just like went the fuck to sleep because I needed some fresh energy to start the day. So today is a new day. Today is my first full day in Ontario. Just kind of want to explore Toronto, see what it's about, see what it's like. And yeah, I'll take a bus to a train, spend the day in Toronto, and then I don't think things are open late here, so I'll probably be back here by like 9 and do it again tomorrow. Just came from the museum and it was cool. They have plenty of art, but not a lot of contemporary stuff. So now I'm walking to go eat something. I found some sort of gastropub with a pretty interesting menu. Get some food and maybe do some like sightseeing of buildings and architecture. Suggested these three. It's a flight, and this first one is so good. It tastes like Prosecco. It's very sweet. So I might be a cider person now. Somehow they always find me. My favorite thing about traveling is that other countries preserve their history so well, and I feel like in America we do, but not really. We prioritize a lot of new things, and I've just gone over like 3 blocks and it's all just been like really old churches and schools and just really beautiful like brick buildings with columns, and it's just gorgeous, honestly. My favorite thing when I travel anywhere in states or out of states is to do vintage and thrift shopping. I like to see what kind of like hidden treasures I can find. I'm gonna do that. I'm gonna get some food and just take it easy today. It kind of takes a long time to get around here. I think that the blocks here are really long. My feet were killing me yesterday. Just to like put it in context, in the city I walk maybe on average about 7,000 steps, like according to my health app. Yesterday I walked 16,000, so I'm gonna be doing a lot of walking here, clearly. Let me get my ass moving because it's gonna take me 2 hours to get there. So while I was walking around, I'm about to walk to lunch, but I stumbled across this like really gorgeous building and I went inside. It turns out it's a courthouse, but I'm just super in love with the architecture. They have like these really weird faces on the outside of the building. I wasn't allowed to go above the first floor, so I couldn't really get a good up close visual of the stained glass windows, but it's a really pretty building. I love courthouses. Too bad they tend to be kind of sad places. Saturday. I'm on my way to Casa Loma right now. Today I organized my schedule so much better because I mapped out things that were close to each other, and I'm gonna knock all those out today. It's cold. Like, I don't know, when I checked my weather app before getting here, I knew it was gonna be warm, and it was like really hot the first few days. But it's like kind of chilly, it's in the 60s, so I had to put on my airplane hoodie. Here I go again, I never finished.
You know I'm a writer, like the high percentage. It's a Mortal Kombat, I'ma catch you in the sixth dimension. Don't be talking in my sleep, cause I know you listening. I travel for my Venus, then get back to Venus. You wearing all your confidence, you really timid. I could bleed if necessary, but you know I'm never switching the bitch. If you walking up to me, you gon' leave for limping. And I cut some homies off for looking like incisions. If you take away the marks, then that's when you can see.
This is Sir Henry's house, worth $80 million today. I think it cost $3 million to build. His wife had a larger room than him, which is kind of crazy. Completely separate living quarters. He had indoor plumbing. He had 50 phones installed in this house when at the time there was only about 200 phones in the city of Toronto. The cool thing is that he gave his servants indoor plumbing as well, and they didn't work on Sundays, and they did get paid a small stipend. This whole thing is so extravagant, it's crazy.
Mary was a go-getter like her husband. When she took over the Girl Guides of Canada in 1912, there were only 250 members. By the time she stepped down 9 years later, there were 17,000, and her guides often visited Casa Loma. It seemed like they were living a wonderful life. But not everyone appreciated Casa Loma. Some people thought it was flamboyant, and that was just the beginning of problems to come.
Today is already like blowing me, like already. I'm taking public transportation mostly to like save money, but it's Sunday. I don't know why I didn't take that into account. Like in the city on Sunday, train service is hella slow. Sometimes certain trains don't even run. I don't know why I thought it would be any different anywhere else. So I'm getting in a car now. I'm gonna get the day started. And have a nice little fun, chill day. All right.
Now all of these buildings out here, are they apartment buildings, most of them, or what are they?
Yeah, mostly the apartment building.
Yeah.
And then in the middle of the city is mostly for office.
Okay.
Mostly office.
Okay.
The US start a business easy. Small business.
Uh-huh.
But here it's difficult.
Really? Why?
Because the paperwork, inspection, and permits, it's a lot of regulation.
Now when I got here it was really hot. Does it normally get hot here? It's not supposed to, right?
No, but the whatever the people saying, the global warming or things.
Yes.
That's why it's getting hot.
Okay. It's hotter than usual.
Unusual. And also now the snow is coming down.
Oh, it's less snow now.
Yeah. A long time ago. Uh-huh. There's lots of snow. It's very difficult. But
I'm on this moonstone, wear me out, I'm his cologne. A cold killer, make a nigga change his time zone. I'm thread strong, but no ties, do not get me wrong. Oh God, I got the recipe, I gon' make a NC nigga rest in peace. I heard they be selling dreams, all they price are melodies. Don't let them trick you with Caucasian subtleties. A real nigga put me on my Q's and P's. Pop quit, tell them test me if you win. I'm these rappers influenced, so competing is useless. I love rap, orange rims, whip sicker than mucus. In the coupe, Kim Possible, don't know what my roof is. And they can't fuck with me, so I guess you hoes is stuck with me. I've been gone for a minute, now these hoes ain't got relief. I think we got the recipe. It's my
my destiny. Now they won't be next to me. I put extra now, pull up like conventions. See. My God, I think we got the recipe. No invite, but I'm still on stick to see. Coming up on funds, now they move at urgency.
Got my nails done, and my nail lady and I were talking just about like the differences between Canada and the US and stuff, and she asked me if I had tried the ketchup chips yet, and I said no. I saw them, they sound disgusting. She said no, they're actually really good, they taste like salt and vinegar chips, which piqued my interest because I do like salt and vinegar chips. So I got them and they were actually really good. I ate the whole thing.
It's the end of my last day here. It's 11:18 right now, and I have to get ready for bed because I have to check out at 12 tomorrow. You guys are gonna get some of my nighttime routine as I do this. This was my first solo international travel trip. The first time you do anything, there's definitely gonna be a learning experience, even if it's like a 10 out of 10, you're always gonna learn something. The very first and like most important thing I learned while being here is that I need to stay in the city that I'm traveling to regardless of how much it costs me. I've spent basically 3 hours of every single day just traveling. And I don't mean like traveling around the city or getting from a restaurant to a shopping center or something. I mean just trying to get to the city. I felt like this urge to wake up at a certain time when in reality, like, I'm on vacation, I shouldn't have to set an alarm. Having to make sure like I'm up and moving by 9, 10 a.m. just because I know that it's gonna take me an hour to get ready and then an hour and a half, sometimes 2 hours just to get to wherever I'm planning to go was not only stressful, but just really time consuming, and I did not enjoy that fact at all. I won't do that again. I did Texas earlier this year and I stayed at two different places. Staying inside of the city of Houston for the second place that I stayed was so helpful because if I did an activity and then wanted to like come back and take a nap or like change my shoes or change my outfit or take a shower, I could do that because I was so close. The amount of times that I was just like in Toronto and had to use the bathroom and had to just hold it until I got to a restaurant or a museum. I'm gonna make sure for future reference, I'm staying in the city. The other thing that I would do differently is find out what activities or places or things that I'm gonna do that are gonna be close together. I was in Chinatown, it felt like damn near every single day. There were so many places I went to several times just because I didn't realize, oh, this place that I wanna eat at, this place that I wanna shop at, this building that I wanna go see are all in the same vicinity. So many days I was in the same spot several times that it was just like such a waste. I also think an interesting thing is maybe I don't need to plan where I'm going to eat. I had reservations tonight at a restaurant and it was the only place on my list that I actually went to. Every other restaurant I went to was just kind of like a spur of the moment. I was in a particular area and I was like, what's around? And I went to go eat. And all of those meals were so fucking good. However, the reservation that I had tonight that I booked maybe a month and a half ago was the worst meal that I had here. It was just a little disappointing. The dessert sucked. I felt like my waitress, she wasn't bad at all, but there were tables around me, right? And she was telling them all different things. Like, this is our best dish here. I heard her say that three times about three different dishes. This is my favorite. I heard her say that several times about several different dishes, you know? And also it was one of the most expensive meals that I had and it just wasn't impressive. Things were kind of like clumsily plated. It was just not ideal. However, when I went to like Antler or Richmond Station or her father's cider and bar or whatever, those were so good and they're places that I would actually go back to if I was ever in Toronto. The other thing is I would pack less shoes. Really only wore two pairs of shoes. And I think that one pair of walking shoes that I can wear on the plane and then maybe one pair of like nicer dressier shoes would have been fine. I would also take time to just ride the streetcar for a few hours. The streetcar to me was my favorite form of public transportation here. It has the best window view. It just has this wide open window so you can see the city so well. It would have been nice to just ride it maybe for like 2 hours and just see where it takes me. And if I see a neighborhood or an area that I like, I could just get off and then hop back on when I wanted to. All right, I'm going to shower now and watch an episode of Scandal and go the fuck to bed. If you want to see any of the little wonders that I picked up or souvenirs that I bought for other people, check the post in my community tab. I have some photos of stuff that I got, like my favorite things that I got while out here. If you're curious about any of the places I listed and want a more in-depth review about like just the best places that I went to, I'll have some Google reviews linked below also. And I will see you guys in a future video. Bye.